like hearing things now. Did you guys hear that? Like, you guys know that my sleeping schedule is a hot mess. You guys know that. But it's gotten so much worse. To the point where I don't even sleep at night anymore. I'm just gonna prime for my eyeshadow because I might as well.
She's priming using chart shape tape, which I've already done.
Usually like 6 or 7 a.m. and I need to fix it. So today I'm using the shade.
So she's using the Violet Voss palette, which transition. I don't have, so I'm gonna use my Jaclyn Hill palette
as my transition. But I'm just running.
Okay, and she's taking like a brown shade. So I'm just going to take butter. Okay, girl, what's next?
Bring this all throughout my crease using the Morphe M441 brush. Okay, so now I'm just going to grab the shade Hine and Dime right here, classic cranberry color. And I'm just going to run this in the crease as well, which is kind of purple. What is happening? Is someone like dying? I don't understand. But like I was saying, I'm just running this throughout the crease just so I kind of bring that rose gold into there, you know what I mean? Okay, so now I'm just going to grab Teddy Bear right here.
Okay, she took Wine and Dine. So I'm going to take... I'm going to take Jax on the same Morphe M441 brush. And she's applying that in her crease as well. Too pigmented. Mine's more like the color she was going for than purple. But that's okay. Okay, what next?
I'm gonna take that deeper into the crease using
Teddy Bear,
a Morphe M514 long, small crease brush. I'm not describing it, but
okay, I don't have that, but I have a Morphe.
And I'm just gonna take this like directly into the crease, mainly like
I have a Morphe M433.
It looks a lot sharper if I have like definition right here. Okay, so it's looking a lot more purple than I.
Wait, yeah. Okay, and I'm just going to take Roxanne and I want to say Buns, just mix those two together and just do what Tina just did, just put it lower down my crease. Okay.
Expected, it looks like I have a black eye, but I'm too shy to care. So I'm just gonna use Kit and Karma. I don't know which one to use because they literally look like different colors.
I have Kit and Karma. It's new.
I really don't know. What? Okay. I'm just gonna use this.
It's my first time using it.
They're the same color, but they're not. But yeah, I'm just gonna do a half-cut crease.
She just went straight in with this, which I am really scared for because I have hooded eyes and no eyelid space that much. So I'm gonna try. Don't try this at home, kids. Oh my god, it's beautiful. This color is so adorable. Okay, I'm just waiting for this to dry.
But once the crease is cut, I'm gonna take Wine and Dine and just like pat it on the outer corner. Just to blend. It kind of feels like a little ombre. And then I'm gonna take Teddy Bear and just like redefine out here. Okay, so I just took off the fallout from under.
Okay. So she took Wine and Dine, which I'm taking Jax. And yeah. And then Roxanne and Bun. I don't have any fallout.
So we're gonna ignore that. But I'm just gonna go ahead and move. Oh my god, that was crazy. I'm just gonna move on to my face. But I'm just gonna use the Estee Lauder Double Wear Foundation, which you guys know I freaking love. I'm gonna go right under here first.
Okay, she didn't prime like on camera, but I'm pretty sure she did prime because sometimes she primes off camera. So I'm gonna prime using my Wet n Wild primer. Just like this. Like, Tina, come on. Tell us what you used, Tina. Okay, and then she used the Estee Lauder.
I'm gonna go ahead and do my concealer. I'll be using Tarte Shape Tape.
She used the Estee Lauder Double Wear Foundation, which I have. I'm in the shade 1N1 Ivory Nude. And she applied that with a sponge. So I'm gonna do that too. Wear this foundation just because it doesn't sit that well on my nose, but if Tina used it, we're using it. Using Tarte Shape Tape underneath her eyes, on her chin. And it's like she brought it on her nose as well.
Okay, so now I'm just gonna go ahead and set.
Okay. Use my Tarte Shape Tape. And I'm not gonna put a lot of Cheetah because then my skin will get all crusty and flaky. So I'm just gonna put a little dot there. And here. That is like more than enough. Okay, and then she blends it out. And then she's setting using the
everything using La Mercier Sun Powder. Translucent.
Okay,
but I'm just gonna skip over this because guys have seen me do this a million times. There's really nothing interesting about setting my face. Okay, so now I'm just gonna go ahead and do my lower lash.
So then I'm gonna Get boulders hit in my face.
I'm just taking that transition color, applying it under there. Then I'm taking Wine and Dine, and then Teddy Bear, and I'm just gonna smoke out my little lash line. Okay, so if you guys ever feel like you went like too far or anything.
First transition shade. Then the last shade.
All you have to do is grab.
Okay, I'm back.
Lower lash line, really quickly. I'm gonna do like a smoky lower lash line. I'm just taking that transition color, applying it under there. Then I'm taking Wine and Dine, and then Teddy Bear, and I'm just gonna smoke out my little lash line. Okay, so if you guys ever feel like you went like too far or anything, all you have to fun
stuff. Dina, you're moving too fast.
Lashes are just like that one thing. It's so annoying to do, but like you gotta do it, you know. But I'm just gonna be using Lily Lashes in Miami.
And then the second shade.
You guys can use the code Tina to save 15% off Lily Lashes at checkout.
What else, Tina? What else?
Do is grab your baking powder. Where did mine go? Yeah, all you have to do is grab your baking powder.
Lashes are.
I'm gonna take my Morphe sponge because it is the best for like sharpening things up. And I'm just gonna take that and go right.
I'm gonna go ahead and do my bronzer.
Stamp it on the outer edges. And now I'm gonna go ahead and do my bronzer and all that fun stuff.
I'm not gonna do the baking powder because mine's fine.
Like that one thing. So annoying to do, but like you gotta do it, you know. But I'm still using Lily Lashes in Miami.
I'm not gonna use those. Those are
expensive. You guys can use the code Tina to save 15% off Lily Lashes at checkout.
I'm just gonna be using my Ardell 120 Black Demi Lashes. These. So I'm gonna apply those off camera and be right back.
Okay,
I don't have that Ofra highlighter palette that she's using, but I have the Ofra and Nikki Tutorials highlighter and Everglow.
I'm just applying it in the places that she applied her.
So I'm just going to be using this. And I'm just going to be taking these two shades right here. More of the gold.
I don't even think she contours
or uses blush in this video. And I love a contour. And she highlighted her nose, which I never highlight my nose, but since she did it, then we're going to do it. She just puts like a little ball on the tip of her nose. Mine just makes me look like I'm greasy.
Super, super nude, like not pink, not gray, not peach, just like straight up nude. So I think I found the right combo. So I'm taking the Ofra liquid lipstick in the shade.
I don't have any of those liquid lipsticks she's using.
It's looking pretty good, but I want it to be a little bit lighter.
I'm gonna use London.
Too Faced Melted Matte Liquid Lipstick in the shade Me So Pretty, just to like really lighten the bitch up, you know. And I'm taking this Maybelline Vivid Hot Lacquer. But this is in the shade Tease. And this is like a lip gloss, and it's super, super nude, so it's gonna be perfect. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I promise I'll be way more functional in my next video.
Tina, wait. Okay, I just use London. And then I'm just going to be using this NYX Butter Gloss in Creme Brulee. My lip color is like not even close match to hers. So yeah. Okay, I'm gonna go fix my hair and I'll be right back. London, and then I'm taking ABH lip stick and Naked.
Look at these oils.
Just to lighten it up, like she said.